Hello and welcome back. So today we're going to be talking about coffee brewing water and some things to consider when discussing this, and maybe even touch on something that you haven't considered yet. So today we're going to be introducing the concept of coffee brewing water, and we're going to discuss a couple different options that are available to you, whether you're a coffee brewing expert or you're a coffee brewer at home that just wants to fiddle around and get better results. So the first thing to really discuss is some basics. So first of all, water from the tap is different everywhere, and that's something that we don't have control over, that can be really bad for consistency. If I'm brewing with tap water from over here and then I go down to New South Wales and I use their tap water, we're gonna be getting different results, just because there's different mineral content. So you have a couple of options. You can go down two main sort of routes. I recommend buying some pure water. So that's distilled or deionized water. There's a brand called Pureau water, and they don't have any mineral content, and it's just stripped back as far as you can go, and then basically introducing your own minerals to it. So if you've got no experience with doing this, there are products available. In front of us, we've got the Third Wave and the Perfect Coffee Water sachets. We also have the Aquacode Coffee Brewing Water. So in this tin of 12, there's liquid. And in these sachets, they are a powder, sort of like these powders over here. And what these are recipes that these companies have made, put together. And they're designed to be added to pure water. Depending on how much pure water, it's a little bit different for each of them and what the recipe calls for, but you can also use your own. For instance, the Aquacode comes with the dilution chart where you can actually go ahead and use one sachet to 5 liters or one sachet to 7 liters, depending on whether you're using either filter or you're using it for espresso. So there is that sense of control of things, but really that's it. It's a kind of streamlined way of adding minerals that are designed for extracting coffee, and it's really simple. It is the more expensive option for two reasons. First being that you need to purchase Pureau, or any other distilled water. Second being you need to purchase the minerals themselves. And one tin is about $50 here, around that. You are looking at some upfront cost, and there are cheaper alternatives. Another option that you can do with the Aquacode or any of these three products here is you can actually go ahead and add that to your tap water. Now, there's already going to be mineral content in your tap water, but for some place like Melbourne, where we are, we actually have really soft water already, and you can go ahead and use these products in our tap water and you'll still have fantastic results. Downside of that is that you don't get to remove any of the minerals that will have a negative sort of result, and it does give you, again, less control. That might be a good thing for some, that might not be worth it for others. On the side, you might have noticed these two jars with some labels and water in them, and these two. So at the top here, we've got bicarb soda, and then at the bottom, we've got Epsom salts. And what I've done is I've gone ahead and made a concentration of both. And one is a buffer solution, and the other is the hardness solution. So I'll go ahead and put a link to that. It's on Barista Hustle's website, where they show you, and they also have a calculator on how to make your own concentrates. So after making these concentrates, you go ahead and put them into another container, and you can either make your own recipe. So essentially what you're doing is every single time you go ahead and use these, you go ahead and make a concentrate, and then you make your coffee brewing water. You're essentially doing the same thing that these guys have done, but you have more control. You can put as much of each concentrate into your coffee brewing water, go ahead, brew with it, see what you get. But yeah, there's a couple of reasons why someone wouldn't do that. It does take up time, energy, effort. You need to go ahead and learn. Some people don't have that investment and they don't want to go ahead and do that. They want someone else to go and do that for them. And that's where the Aquacode comes in. They also have their own recipes. So the Aquacode is already pre-made. They've had an expert go ahead and design these minerals instead of you doing that yourself. So yeah, just a really quick short video on sort of an introduction. There's a lot to it that I don't understand, that I'm still learning. And yeah, let me know what you think. Let me know if you have any experience with coffee brewing water and what your thoughts were. I'm not so much comparing any of these companies. I just have them on display to show you a couple different products available to you. So with that being said, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope this has started a conversation or given you some direction onto what solutions are more appropriate for you. If you have any questions at all, drop a comment down below, and yeah, we'll see you next time.